Hello students, today I will be taking your fifth session under the chapter Synthetic Fibers and Plastics. Before I take up today's topic, let's do a quick recap of what we have learned in the previous session. In the previous session, we learned about the characteristics and uses of nylon. So what do we mean by nylon? Nylon is derived from two places where it was co-formed, that is New York and London. Second thing we learnt about nylon is that it is the first synthetic fiber. It is the first completely synthetic fiber discovered during 1931. We also learnt some of the characteristics of nylon, that it is very strong. It is stronger than a steel wire. We learnt that it is lustrous. It is easy to maintain. Easy to wash, does not wrinkle, does not absorb water, and many more. Nylon has many advantages. Therefore, you know, it's cheaper also, and therefore it's used. It has n number of uses. Like, what are the uses of nylon? Nylon is very strong, so it is used in making ropes. For drying clothes or for many reasons, and also used in making ropes for parasailing and rock climbing, wherein the rope has to be strong. So nylon ropes are used for parasailing and in rock climbing. Other than that, it is used in making clothing, socks, fishing net. What else? I have not mentioned, but there are many other uses. Like even nylon is used in making tire cords. Okay. That we learned that it is made use in sleeping bags, car belts, isn't it? So car seat belts, I need to say. So these are all the uses of nylon. Today I will be taking up polyester and acrylic together. Okay. So polyester is another important synthetic fiber. Polyester. So today we will be learning about polyester and acrylic. First, I will take up polyester. So polyester is a synthetic fiber which is made up of ester molecules. So it is made up, basically the raw material here is esters. Okay, what do we mean by ester? You know, natural substances like fruits contain ester in them. Therefore, the fruit gets its smell. That fruity smell is due to the presence of this chemical called as ester. Ester is not derived from a natural fiber, but it is a chemical which can be prepared in the lab, but it is present in natural substances also. Polyesters, as I told you, they are made up of monomers called as esters. These esters give fruit its smell. Rather, we don't derive esters from natural fruits to prepare polyester. It is chemically made here. The chemical called as ester is used to make polyester. Here, ester becomes a monomer for polyester. Hope you remember, poly means many. Ester is the monomer. So, many ester monomers combine or are linked chemically to make polyester. So, in natural substances like fruits also, esters are present which give the fruit its smell. Okay. So, in a way you can say that the fiber which is derived from polyester and the fabric which is made using polyester will have a good fruity smell. Now, polyesters, there are many types of polyesters depending on what ester it is. Ester is chemically ethyl ethanoate, methyl ethanoate. You won't understand if I tell you now. You will understand when you come to 10th standard in the chapter carbon and its compound. We can learn when an acid, carboxylic acid, is made to combine with an alcohol, we get esters. Rather, you need not worry about it now. Okay, esters can be made up of different, maybe of different types. Okay, and based on that, we can obtain different types of polyesters. The two important polyesters we are going to talk about is pterylene and polyethyl terephthalate, that is PET. Now, pterygin is a polyester which can be derived into fine thread, very fine thread. If a question like this would come, for example, let me tell you, which is the synthetic fiber which can be derived into very fine thread? That would be pterylene, a polyester. It can be derived into very, very, very thin fibers. It is used to make fabric because it can be easily woven into a fabric, just like other fibers. And pterylene or any other polyester for that sake, if I talk about characteristics of polyesters, it remains crisp. It is easy to maintain, that is, it remains crisp, easy to wash, so wrinkle free, so it has a good smell also, gives a good smell also. Now, what are the characteristics of polyester? In general, polyester, whichever it may be, remains crisp. It does not need ironing. It means it's wrinkle free. It has a good smell. Now, pterylene, being one of the polyester, also has the same properties. And we'll take a ethyl terephthalate later. And therefore, pterylene is used in making dress materials, shirts. You might have heard about wrinkle-free shirts, isn't it? Likewise, there are dress materials which doesn't need ironing. It's wrinkle-free dress materials and shirts. Commonly, pterylene is used for making dress materials and shirts. Otherwise, it can be used for making curtains also. There are many other uses. Other than that, they can be combined with other natural fibers like cotton and wool. So you get, when pterylene is combined with cotton, you get pterycotton. Okay, pterylene can be mixed with wool to give pterywool, and those can be again used to make dress materials, shirts, curtains, and many other things. The second important and very popular polyester is polyethylene terephthalate, wherein P is silent. It is polyethyl terephthalate, that is PET. Polyethyl terephthalate, which is called PET. You might have heard of PET bottles, isn't it? So it is used in making bottles, tiffin boxes, and other utensils. They look like plastic, rather they are made up of synthetic fibers called as polyester. This made use in making bottles, utensils, photographic films, wires, etc. So these are the uses of polyethyl terephthalate, that is PET. So what are the uses of pterylene? It is used in making dress materials and shirts, and it can be combined, mixed with other natural fibers like cotton and wool to make pterywool and pterycot. Likewise, these esters and many other polyesters in general can be combined with polyester can be combined with cotton to give polycot. You might have heard of different materials like polycot, and the same thing, polyester, if it is combined with wool, it is called as polywool. So you can combine natural fibers with that of polyesters and make different materials, or different, a combination of materials which looks different, which has a different texture, which has a different look, that is new appearance. Okay, so these are the use of polyesters. Next, coming to acrylic. Now, acrylic is the last type of synthetic fibers to you, which has similar properties to that of wool. So, it can be called as the best substitute for wool. So, where do we get wool from? We get wool from sheep, right? The fleece of sheep is shear to get wool. So, let's not take this trouble. And also, you know that wool, since it is from a natural source, it is costlier also. And the process, because the processing of wool from sheep is a long process, which you have learned in the last year. So, and also, I told you it hurts the sheep also. So, let us allow it to live. So, the best substitute for wool we already have now. Whatever you get, sweaters or the sweatshirts, which just look like wool, is not wool, but it is from acrylic, a synthetic fiber which is just like wool. The best substitute for wool, and you cannot differentiate. Now, like I told you that all the synthetic fibers can be dyed into different colors. Likewise, acrylic can also be dyed into a variety of colors. Okay, so it can be dyed into a variety of colors. So when I say characteristics of acrylic, it's just that of wool. So it gives warm feeling when worn. So it can be just made, fiber can be obtained just like that of wool. So it can be woven like sweater. So it is used in making sweatshirts, socks, hand gloves, etc. Wherever you use wool, in that place you can use acrylic. Now they are using, rather we cannot make up, it is just similar to that of wool. Now, as I told you, it can be dyed into a variety of colors. That is one plus point. It is cheaper, it is affordable, therefore it has become very famous. So acrylic is much famous, popular than that of wool now, because it's cheaper, it's affordable, it's the best. It can be dyed into a variety of colors. So these are the characteristics and uses of acrylic. What are the uses? Sweaters, socks, gloves, extra. Sweaters or sweatshirts mean the same. So even t-shirts which look like sweaters are also made up of acrylic. So these are the uses of acrylic. So what did we learn in this session? We learned about polyester, whose monomer is, which is made up of ester molecules, which has sweet smell or fruity smell. Fruits, natural fruits also have esters in them. Therefore, they get the smell. Smell is due to the esters present in them. There are many other uses of esters, but it is not linked to this. So let's not talk about it. And most popular type of polyester is terylen and PET, that is polyethyl terephthalate. Uses of terylen is that it is used in making dress materials and shirts. The characteristics of polyester is that it is does not get wrinkled. It's easy to maintain, easy to wash, and they remain crisp. Therefore, terylen also has the same characteristics. Polyethyl terephthalate is a little harder polyester. So it can be used in making bottles, PET bottles, whichever, and in making utensils, photographic films, and vials. So then these are the use and characteristics of polyesters. And we came to acrylic. Acrylic is just a substitute of wool. It has all the properties similar to that of wool, but it is derived chemically, and the monomer of acrylic is acrylamide. Okay, acrylamide. That is AMIDE. So, let me write it clearly. So, the monomer for acrylic is acrylamide. So, acrylamide molecules are chemically linked to one another to get polyacrylamide, that is acrylic, which is called as acrylic. So, it's cheaper, it's affordable, it can be dyed into a variety of colors. Therefore, they are the best substitute for wool. They are they just have similar properties to that of wool, that is it gives warmth. So sweat, they can be used in making sweaters, socks, gloves, etc. So whatever you see which looks like which is made up of wool is not actually that wool which we obtain from sheep, but it is acrylic nowadays. Thank you. So then the next session we'll take up the next topic. Now bye.